Okay, now today we will see the other IoT devices. Up to previous slides we have gone through the Raspberry Pi. Now we will see other IoT devices, which is your number one is PC Duino, like your Arduino. There is one more IoT device, or like your Raspberry Pi, PC Duino is there, BeagleBone Black is there, QB board is there, and another important one is your Arduino. Now this is what the PC Duino is. The structure or the board will look like this. Again, this board will have all the ports for your general purpose input output, for attaching the sensors and actuators. It will have your HDMI converter, power supply, USB ports are there. All the ports which we have already discussed in the block diagram, all those ports are available again on this PC Duino also. Then this is BeagleBone Black. The name itself suggests that the color of this board will be black. And again, it will have your what? All the types of ports, like that we have already discussed in the Raspberry Pi. It will have your graphic port, it will have your input output ports for your sensors, power supply, your display board, and all the types of ports are again available on this BeagleBone Black. We are not going to see all those boards in the detail because they are just for the study purpose. We are not going to use these boards in the practical also. As I told you, the most important boards are your number one Raspberry Pi and Arduino. Only we are going to see these two boards in detail. And this is another type, that is your QB board. Again, you can observe it has USB port, HDMI converters, everything is there. Only the difference is that all those ports are located at different location on the board. If you remember the diagram of all these boards, somewhere the USB port is on the left side or right side, on the top or on the bottom. But the functionality and the number of ports will be the same on all these types of your IoT devices. And this is another type, that is your Arduino board, Arduino Uno. The name is written here. You can identify which type of Arduino it is. So this is Arduino Uno. It has various pins here. These are the ports, again power supply. Now we will see the Arduino board in detail here in this unit. From here onwards we are going to see the Arduino board in detail. So what is Arduino? Arduino is an open source electronics platform based on your easy to use hardware and software. Just like your Raspberry Pi, it is also your what? Open source. And it will be useful for your what? Attaching the different hardware and installing the various softwares on your onboard application. This Arduino is able to read inputs just like your light of a sensor, finger on a button, or Twitter message. What exactly Arduino is going to do is, it will going to read the data from the external devices, either external hardware or external software. On the basis of input, it will going to generate some output. The output can be activating the motors, just an example of your actuation. The output is nothing but the actuation, input is nothing but the sensing. So it will going to turn the input into the output, just like your turning on the motor, turning on the LED glow on off, that is the activity of your actuation. So this is what the output generation is, and it will going to publish something online, storing the data on your what? Cloud, or storing the data on the server is the part of your what? Generating the output. You can tell your board what to do by sending a set of instructions to the microcontroller on the board. All these boards have microcontroller installed on them. And what is the use of microcontroller? Microcontroller will going to receive the data, and on the basis of data it will going to process what exactly what should happen with that particular data, whether the data should be processed, whether it should be sent to the cloud, whether the data is going to be processed locally or on the server side or at the cloud side. So this is what the task of your what? Controller is. The controller will going to control the data received on the board. To do so, you are use the Arduino programming language, which is based on your wiring, and we are going to use the Arduino software, that is your IDE, based on processing. So There is one programming language specially for Arduino. They have developed their own programming language, Arduino programming language, and we need to use the IDE for your Arduino, that is your Arduino software. Again, it is available, as you can see that this is your what? This is open source, that's why this software is available freely on the net. Only what you need to do is you need to Google it, Arduino software, you will get the its setup, you need to download the setup and you can start using this IDE for your Arduino. Now why to use the Arduino? Because it is simple and accessible. Its user experience is what? Very simple. User experience means just like the board. You can easily identify which board, which port is USB port, which is your Ethernet port. All these things are what? Simple and easily accessible. Number one, then Arduino software is easy to use for beginners. If you are a beginner or if the first time user, if you are trying to use the Arduino, then it will be very easy to use for your what? Beginners. It is flexible enough for the advanced user. Once you will be gone through the phase of beginner and you will become the advanced learners, then it will be very flexible. It runs on your Mac, Windows as well as Linux. As you are aware about that, the Raspberry Pi runs only on Linux platform. Whereas your Arduino will run on your Mac OS, your Windows OS as well as your Linux OS. This is main advantage of your what Arduino is. Teachers and students use it to build low cost scientific instruments. If you need to develop the low cost application, then you are going to use the Arduino. Then teachers and students can use it to prove the chemistry and physics principle. Again, it is not related with us. In the school, if you are aware about that, the school going students have the Arduino in their practicals and they are developing the Arduino projects when they are in 11th or 12th science. In the science, they have various physics, what we can say, experiments on the basis of Arduino. So they are using what? Arduino in their schools. Or to get started with the programming and robotics, if you wish to do the career in the robotics, then you should use the Arduino, because you all are aware about the robots and robots are controlled mostly by the Arduino. So if you are interested in the robotics, then you should go with the Arduino only. Why is it so popular? It is low cost or very inexpensive. Then cross platform, as we know that it runs on your Mac OS, Windows and Linux, that's why it is cross platform. It is simple and its programming environment is very clear. It is open source, as we already discussed. So these are some points on the basis of which the Arduino makes it very popular than your Raspberry Pi or other IoT devices. This is your Arduino. This Arduino have various power pins, analog pins and other your digital pins, your reference pin, ground pin, receiver and transmitter pin. So these are the various pins. Those pins are available on your Arduino board. Other things are your, this is your IC, these are your other ports, USB port, your Ethernet port, your power supply port, all those ports are there. But the only important part is your what? These different pins mounted on your Arduino board. So which microcontroller is used in your Arduino? In Arduino, the most important microcontroller is Atmega. The very first point is, it uses Atmega 328P. That is the most recent board, most recent microcontroller used in your Arduino. It has various digital input output pins. That is total 14 digital input output pins are there on the Arduino board. It has 6 analog input pins or 8 analog input pins, depend on the board. Again, board आप कौन सा board use कर रहे हो उसके ऊपर depend है, उसमें 6 है या 8 रहने वाले है. The DC current per input output pin is 40 milliampere. उसका current कितना रहेगा हर एक pin के लिए लगने वाला? 40 milliampere का रहेगा. these are some technical terms that we should just remember. We should not focus on much this pins. Flash memory will be of 32 KB, SRAM will be of 2 KB, and EEPROM will be of 1 KB. I hope you all are aware about these terminologies, or you already gone through these terminologies. What is EEPROM, what is SRAM, the size of the different types of RAM and ROM will be like this. We are not going to see this part in detail because I consider that you all are aware about what is SRAM and what is EEPROM. You are aware about that? Okay. Now digital pins. The various digital pins available on the Arduino board will be accessible using these commands: pin mode, digital read, and digital write. Whatever data you need to read from the Arduino, all the data can be read with the help of this command. And if you wish to write some data on the Arduino, you are going to write the data using your digital write. Whereas pin mode is used to set the particular pin. Before using any of the pin, you need to set that pin using your pin mode command. All those functions are your built-in Arduino functions, and those functions can be written in the Arduino software, which is you can freely download it and you can access it. Each pin has internal pull-up resistor which can, okay. So every pin will going to do the activity of your high and low. Whatever will be the output on each and every pin, it will be either high or it will be either low with the help of your digital write function. So either it will generate high or it will generate your low signal, each and every your digital pin. As the name suggests that the nature of the pin will be digital. So it will have only two values, either 0 or 1, just like either high or low. So this is the functionality of your what? Digital pin. The maximum current per pin is 40 milliampere that we already discussed in previous slide. Again, it has two serial digital pins, 0 and 1, that is your receiver and transmitter. If you remember the previous diagram, in that these two pins are mentioned there. There is one board, your Arduino Mini, and another board is your LilyPad. There are multiple boards. The name are like this: LilyPad, Arduino, or dissimilarly. Like these are the various boards. This is the functionality of your what? These serial pins. They have interrupt, external interrupts. If you remember the controller, I guess in second year you have gone through the interrupt microcontroller programming. So you can give the external interrupts on pin number 2 and 3. Again, we are not going to see what is interrupt, how to give the interrupt in detail. I am assuming that you all are aware about the giving the interrupt. So that interrupt can be given on your Arduino using pin number 2 and 3. Again, these are some other pins that are available on your what? Arduino. This is one board, LilyPad, and this is another board, your Dissimila. These are the names of your different Arduino boards. So depending on the board, the pin number will going to change. Just like Raspberry Pi model 1, 2, 3A, 3B, they have the name LilyPad, Dissimila, and so on. Again, these are your 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, and 11. These are your PWM pins which are available on your Atmega board. Then it has Bluetooth module for at pin number 7. You can attach the Bluetooth module on pin number 7 of your digital pins. You can attach external Bluetooth on your Arduino. Then LEDs can be attached on pin number 13 of your digital pin. It will going to generate either high value or low value. High means LED will be turned on, and low means LED will be turned off. This is what the pin number where you can attach the LEDs. Now they have various analog pins also. Analog input 0 as pin number 14. That means analog 0 to analog 5. A0 to A5, total 6 analog pins are there on your what? Arduino board. starting from A0 to A5, means total 6 pins. And other pin, analog pin number 6 and 7 will be for your Bluetooth and mini use. They cannot be used as your digital pins. These are your power pins available on your what? Arduino board. 4 power pins are there. V in, generally called as your 9 volt pin, 5 volt, 3.3 volt and ground. And other than the previous pins, it has 2 other pins, reference and reset. The reference pin will be used for giving the analog reference. If you wish to give the analog reference, that can be given with this. Again, this pin is very rarely used in your Arduino. Mostly users avoid using this kind of pin because the main functionality of this pin is not very much aware for the IT or computer engineers. If we will be from the electronics background, then we will come to know what exactly this is. So we usually what avoid using this pin. And last one will be your reset. You all are aware about the functionality of reset. What reset will going to do? If you press it, your board will be automatically get reset and it will start from it will again restart or again it will be reset from the initial value.